to know he's coming back for these group of people here. Yeah, you're going to have some of our people that scattered that look like the other nations. That's Revelation 7.
Yeah.
But they know the bulk of these people are right here in America, and they see us waking up. So they're sending out top theologians and scholars, gatekeepers, to try to plant the seed of doubt.
That's why they keep coming and saying stuff. But it's in, you can't tell me what to do if it's in my mind.
Right. Yep, it's biblical.
So and basically, I was telling them in a nice way, don't send nobody else home. That's done. I really, that's sealed up.
Right, right.
Once the Holy Spirit opens and you say, fine, you go in there. Seal it up, it's in the Bible, hear the scriptures. Two of them, you can send it to them, the master word.
Right,
two
right.
Of them, it's done.
Right,
so
right.
I did that. I don't send nobody else home.
Right, you're right. And then, you can see in that devil's face, he's getting scared. And that's why I brought that quote on what Hitler said. He said, the greatest secret was, and that's before he died. He told the soldier, yeah, he said the greatest secret was the Negro nationality that had tried Judah. That was the greatest secret. Remember he said it? Yeah. He said the Jewish, the Illuminati, they'll keep that secret at all costs. But they don't understand that it was prophesied that the Israelites would wake back up. I'm going to read it.
That is coming. That's why this is the time. It's coming back up. And I had a vision, too, some years ago with the Father sent to me that related to some of what we see now.
Right.
And I remembered it. I said, did you tell me?
I was observing here. So you gotta, because, and before I read this scripture too, this is mainly for the camera. You see this shooting they had, right?
Yes, they had a good one.
And those are all crisis actors. That was all set up. Like you keep telling people. Happened right after July the 4th. And that was the Most High to show you Negroes that you were never free. That got nothing to do with you.
No, it doesn't.
That independence garbage got nothing to do with you, man. That's what you're getting gunned down, man. That's the irony of that. As soon as Negroes got finished with they fought ribs, the next day you start getting shot down.
And
like we said, you see? We've been always keep. This is coming. They want. Hey, all this stuff is staged, man. The end game is this and that. This and that. This and that. Jacob's trouble. But it was prophesied that we would wake back up. I'll read it real quick. See, what we say is coming to life. It's coming. It's coming. It's happening. Right before your eyes. Like, wow. And every week is something. If it's not some bombing or some shooting or some celebrity dropping dead,
yeah,
or brain exiting the EU, every week or something.
$3 trillion yeah. Lost.
And I realized that.
And a lot of people didn't even know.
Yeah.
I picked that up for myself because a lot of people didn't know. That's matters.
Yeah. Like I said, this is it, man. This is it. And the Most High is showing you. It's not like before you have one thing happen here, then
no,
a year
like
later, it's just every week. Whack. Constantly.
That's like birthdays.
Yeah.
It's going and it's getting closer to
the birthday. That's right. The Lord said men's heart failing them because they see what's about to happen on the earth. That's why I said this. I'm going to read Hosea chapter 1, verse 9. Then said the Most High, call his name Lo Ami, for ye are not my people, and I will not be your power. This was he was upset with us for breaking his laws,
yeah.
And he allowed us to be scattered, and allowed our enemies to rule over us.
Right.
So then he said, Lo Ami, which in Hebrew means, ye are not my people, and
yeah.
I'm done with you. This is why the Son of Man came on the scene,
yeah.
To save that which was lost.
Right, that's what he said, the lost house of Israel.
That's what he said, the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? And the majority of people right now are still lost sheep. Alright, but it says, Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea, which cannot be measured nor numbered. And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there it shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living power. Throughout every captivity, one thing we always had was our nationality. When it was the Egyptians, the Babylonians, the Persians, the Greeks, the Romans during the time of the Lord, we always knew who we were. But this was a unique captivity.
The Babylonian captivity.
Yeah. But even Daniel knew he's an Israelite.
They still knew.
He was an Israelite.
But they changed their name.
Yeah, they changed their name to Babylon. Yeah, Bedrack and Abednego. Yeah.
Daniel
was
to,
Belshazzar? I can't remember.
Belteshazzar.
Yeah, yeah. Those are Babylonian. Even Esther.
And none of those things.
Esther is that's not her name.
I know it's not. Yeah. It's a Babylonian.
But she's still, because she was in the Persian Empire at that time. Oh, okay, okay. You ever see pictures of the Lord that they draw?
Yeah, I've seen some.
Of Yahweh Shai?
Yes, I've seen some.
There's a talented brother, man. That brother, he's great.
And I also saw how he was
right. It says this. I'm gonna keep reading. It says, but like I was saying, this captivity was unique because this was the only captivity where we actually forgot our nationality was beaten out of us.
Yeah,
especially starting with Columbus when he took down the Northern Kingdom, the Hispanic tribe. He beat their nationality out of them, tortured them, and they accepted this Christianity along with this white Jesus. They even show your roots. He said, what's your name, boy? He said, Kuta Kente, and he beat him. Wow, what's your name, boy? Kuta Kente, wow. Until he said, Toby. Yeah. Toby. And you see the other slaves was like, damn, they broke him.
No meaning to the name. You know, one of the things I noticed is our names always connected us to God, to the Most High.
It represented a certain characteristic.
Yeah, a characteristic, you have to pay whatever it is. Salvation, whatever the thing is, but when they changed it, it had no money.
Nope.
No connection. They severed the connections to the Most High.
And you know how they really severed the connection? Uh-huh. Well, how the Most High severed the connection from us and Him?
Yeah.
He took away the name.
Yeah.
Because Jesus,
every
Jesus.
Time he calls, I'm going to call you Abraham. He changed
his name from
Abraham to reflect.
That's how they draw Him down.
I've seen this one.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've seen the face, just the face part.
Oh, okay.
Somebody had a movement in the face.
Okay, and that's an accurate description right there.
Oh, yes. Yes, sir.
Well, they show you now that that's the closest description according to the scripture yet.
That one is.
Yeah. Eyes is a flame of fire. That's the Lord right there. That's what scripture says. Great fear fell upon all those who saw him. But let me finish this out. Hosea, I forgot. So he said, I'm going to read that one more time. Oh yeah, you know, after this week out, you know I had to be out here. This was a crazy week, man. You had that July the 4th and you had all these police shootings. Then you have police getting shot back, supposedly. Yeah. So a lot of those are stage events.
Yeah.
But the agenda's still there.
Yeah.
The agenda's still there. You know what I mean? Like you kept telling people that New World Order's coming. But like the Lord said, in a place you were told, you are not my people, that's really talking about America. Because we were told we were niggas, African, and all this madness. He said, they shall know we are the sons of the living power.
They sent somebody to ask me something about scripture. I'll tell you that after
the day. All right. It says, then shall the children of Judah, which the children of Judah is the southern kingdom.
Yes.
Judah, Benjamin, Levi, that's the southern kingdom. And the northern kingdom is the rest, the 10 tribes. It says, then shall the children of Judah and the children of Israel be gathered together. Where did they be gathered together? Mainly over here. Because this was the place of our last captivity. And appoint themselves one head, which is the Lord. And they shall come up out of that land, America. For great shall be the day of Jezreel, which is of Israel, man. That's time is coming now. And the way he's going to bring the tribes together is through affliction, persecution. He's going to show you who your enemy is. These race riots is going to happen. He's going to show you that this man was always your enemy. He's Esau in the time of his downfall. That's what the Bible says.
Well, I found that out.
Yeah. Matter of fact, let me read this precept, and then I may jump into my topics. Baruch, chapter 2, verse 28. You got Apocrypha yet, or no? No?
No, I go through the 66 books. The Holy Spirit has been with me.
Yeah, man, you gotta get the Apocrypha. How you call it? It says, because if you get the 1611, it's all together. 1611 King James, they're both is one. That's why it says you have authorized King James version. Yeah, this is and there was a council in the 1800s that they stripped they broke the two apart. That's why it says KJV Apocrypha.
Yeah.
Because the Apocrypha was placed between the Old and New Testament.
Yeah.
In the original King James.
Okay.
And in the 1800s, the Catholics had a council and said, why is this included in there? Let's take it out. It's just a history book. But no, it's deadly prophecies in here. Deadly. Deadly prophecies. You ever heard of the prophet Ezra?
Yes.
Oh my God. The things he saw was comparable to St. John the Revelator, but probably with a little bit better clarity. Because he saw almost the same thing he saw. But the Most High even went back to Adam. And why he made Adam go off. To where we are today. He even saw the second coming. He saw the elect being crowned. He saw all of that in Ezra. Matter of fact, I'm going to read it after the scripture. Baruch chapter 2 verse 28. Matter of fact, to prove Baruch belong in here, before I read Baruch. Jeremiah 45:1. To show you the two belong together. Jeremiah 45:1. Deadly prophecy. And I'm going to read some after. Jeremiah 45 verse 1. How's everything with you other than that? Good?
I'm okay. God's taking care of me. He's letting these people know. Even when I'm at the lowest of the low, I'm still going to have her do what I want. You're never going to take care. They can't take my relationship. You could break everything up. He's not letting me mess with that. That's why I'm saying you do the same.
Oh, yeah. That's a good thing, man. See, they can't take your faith away.
That seed. This is what they're trying to break. It's like they want you to say, oh, they did this, they did that to me, and I'm not going to serve him. No. Even more so.
Even more so, yep. And now you see the end approaching, you got to go with an order.
Oh, yeah. It's coming.
That's why I'm going to read, approve the two belong together.
Yeah.
Jeremiah 45:1. The word that Jeremiah the prophet spake unto Baruch, the son of Neriah, when he had written these words in a book at the mouth of Jeremiah in the fourth year of Joachim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, saying, So he told Baruch to write these words down, but Baruch writing is not him.
Okay.
It's in him.
Because it has it and then it doesn't show it.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Okay.
Baruch writing is him.
Okay.
That's why it says,
I was telling people, one of the things they could tell. Yeah,
I'm going to see. See? Baruch right here. So this is missing. So yeah. Jeremiah told Baruch, write these words down. That's how you know
so
the two belong. Yeah.
These words down. Okay, here's the word.
Yeah. And but you realize Baruch writing is not here. It's missing.
Okay.
There you go, right here. That's why. That's how you know the two.
You know, I was telling people on my side, make sure you have paper copies of the Bible. All of mine were destroyed. But one of these is wise. It was all these online copies.
Oh, yeah.
They
that's...
have hacked my apps so that I can use. They hacked my Hebrew dictionary. They hacked my. There's a couple of books I had like backups, but they, you know, the online stuff, they can just
That's why I have the app right now, but I always have the physical, physical
and
book.
You have to have it in your heart, memorized. That's how I know it's some of the best stuff.
Yeah.
You know, because I have it.
Yeah, that's why we can go to scripture, because we study.
Yeah.
That's why I said it. Baruch chapter 2, verse 28. This is a prophecy that goes exactly with Hosea. And this is why they had no business. Scripture said if any man would take out the things which was written, the Most High shall also take out his name in the book of life. And Revelation the 22nd chapter.
Yeah.
So they had no business having a council on saying what should and shouldn't be in the book. Or trying to create, or trying to create these different Bibles, man. Because they're being crafty with the wording. And when you do comparative studies between the King James and other Bibles, a whole lot of Bible verses are omitted. They just take them out.
They do. They take you right through them.
So, yeah.
But you know how you know? If you study the Bible, I studied from the King James.
Only
and I've
King
read
James.
Some of the other Bibles.
You know he was black, right?
I saw that too.
Yeah.
I saw that too.
He was one of the last black nobility. I think Queen Charlotte was like the last one. But Oliver Cromwell, when they came in there,
that's when
there's a term called the Black Irish, the Black Scots.
Yeah.
Because black people ruled that area.
Yeah.
And they dealt with white women, but it's still based on the seat of your father.
Yeah.
And those descendants, they put them in slavery towards the Caribbean.
Yeah.
Why? Because it was all in the curses.
Yeah.
No matter where we was, that curse would fall upon us.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah. Because you came up with the Most High.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do something, do it.
No matter if they look like this guy right here, but their forefathers were black.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I have a picture of him. I'll show you later on. But it says this. Baruch chapter 2, verse 28. As thou spakest by thy servant Moses in the day when thou didst command him to write thy law before the children of Israel, saying, if he will not hear my voice, surely this very great multitude shall be turned into a small number among the nations where I will scatter them. When the main place scattered is America.
Yeah.
But he said, for I knew that they would not hear me because it is a stiff-necked people. So the Most High said he knew our people weren't listening. Because we're hard-headed, stiff-necked, rebellious. The scripture tells you that.
Yeah, yeah.
He said, but it's the point. But in the land of their captivities, they shall remember themselves. And that's happening now. Now you're waking up now. Oh, I'm not a Negro. I'm not a West Indian. I'm not a Haitian. I'm not a Native American. I'm a son of the Most High. I'm from the tribe of Ephraim. I'm from the tribe of Gad. I'm from the tribe of Judah. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, that came right up to me. That's why I had to look at that chart again. I said, that's probably the Holy Spirit telling me to go back and look at some of that stuff. He came right up to me talking about, and this is before I came looking up. He said, if you see the tree, I'm Ephraim. I thought he was talking about his name. You know, just his regular name. His Puerto Rican. And he said, I'm Ephraim and you, Judah. I was like, yeah. And then so he started sitting down telling me about how his family.
That's the most high. And any
and
brother,
so
yeah.
He just came out and looked at me. He was so happy. And he said, and I didn't know what they had, all this stuff. And I was like, yeah, you know. So it's what you're saying.
That's the most high, yeah. That's why people like James White trying to come forth, because they don't want that. But he got severed by the sword of truth. Ephesians 6. This is the sword of the Most High. And he's so much of a devil, he didn't want to use the Bible.
See, I thought that too. That's why I'm
sorry. Yeah, it's the scriptures.
You don't talk to me. Don't talk. If it's in there, you can forget it.
Yeah.
My ears are closed.
Yeah, he said, why don't you get this book and that book? His his goal is to get you out of this.
No.
Because he can't deal with this.
You go down to that.
Yep. Nah, the Most High ain't dealing with books.
If it ain't by the Most High, I'm not trying to get you scared.
The Most High made it simple. He put the Spirit on certain men to put all the scrolls together.
Inspired.
Yep. And put it in one book for us to read.
It's God's book. It's inspired by God.
And you see how they put it neat for you? Because the old Bibles, they didn't have chapters and verses.
Right.
Or even in the, if you wanted to read Jeremiah, you had to get the entire scroll and read exactly what Jeremiah said. But they put it neat for you. That's the Spirit of the Most High.
Yeah.
So he made it easy. So it's no excuse. This is what we're dealing with.
Yeah.
I'm going to read verse 31.
That's why they destroyed all my paperwork. I had a beautiful Bible.
That's what they're trying to tell you.
And it had all the components in the back of that King James Version. And they just destroyed it.
Yeah, but like we said, we having it in our heart now. Verse 31, I'll read this real quick. And shall know that I am the Lord their power, for I will give them a heart and ears their hair, which is with the elect. The elect. Verse 32. And they shall praise me in the land of their captivity. And that's what we're doing now. We in the land of our captivity, but we coming out and we praising the Most High. We crying unto him. And he said, what? And think upon my name. You hear that, Nate? Are you other demons out there who teach that the name of the Lord don't matter? The name of the Lord does matter, man. And it's only can be uttered in the Hebrew. His father name is Yahweh. Yah means he. Yahweh means to be. He to be, or he exists, or he is everything. Okay? He's in and he's everything, man. And his son name is Yahweh Shai, kingly called Jesus. Jesus is Greek, man.
It is.
That's not, the Lord name was in Greek. His name was what? In Hebrew. Yah means he, Yahweh Shai means to save or to deliver. He saves or he delivers. So that's what we say, Yahweh Bahashim, in the name of his son, Yahweh Shai. You see what I'm saying? I mean, I can write it down for you. That's the name of the Most High and his son. Matter of fact, let me pull that quick and I'm going to jump to these topics, because the awakening of the 12 tribes has already begun. And the elites of this society are getting scared. They're getting frightened. But don't think this white man just going to go out like that. He's going to go out a very sore loser. He's going to slander you. Oh, these guys are, these guys are violent. They bomb guns and bombings. He gonna start up a slander campaign. And go after the prophets. For the scripture says, when an enemy shall come in as a flood, the Spirit of the Most High shall lift up a standard against them. Spiritual power. Alright? All we gotta do is hold on, man. Because the road to the kingdom is gonna be a very bumpy one. But the scripture talks about, scripture talks about enduring. Yeah, we gotta endure.
They done put me that water.
Yeah.
That was a mistake.
Yeah.
Because the Father made sure I have this. He taught me painting, how to draw, how to present the scriptures.
Right, right.
In a different way.
Right, right. I'm going to read this now to go into the name of the Lord real quick.
Yeah.
Zephaniah 3 and 9. It says, Zephaniah 3 and 9. For then will I turn to the people a pure language. What's the pure language? The Hebrew. When you react, yeah, the pure language is, yeah, the pure language is a Hebrew, not Yiddish, which is mixed with German and whatever bastard tongue the Hebrew they
speak. With
yeah,
that's how I study.
Yeah, that's the pure language that the Most High dealing with. It says, "For then will I turn to the people a pure language, that they may all call upon the name of the Lord to serve Him with one consent." You gotta call His name in the pure language, the Hebrew. That's what He's dealing with. See, when you get deep into the knowledge, you don't want to hear Jesus. No. And others, Jehovah, he's not dealing with that.
So he doesn't respond to it. Because I know for me, when I pray in the name of Jesus, I'm
dying. Yeah, because maybe, yeah,
because he's looking at Jehovah.
Because the elect at that time, you all calling on that name, and he did deliver you in situations.
Yeah,
but he now he's coming to the time now where you got to learn the full knowledge of the Most High.
Well, maybe that's why he's putting it in your heart to
yeah.
Look at the
Yeah, and that's because if you are the elect, you're going to come into the knowledge of the name anyway. Because it was meant for you to get it.
Yeah,
you were preordained to get it.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
I was pushed that from
yeah. You were preordained to get it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to get into this now. Let me see. It says, Let me get these now, because I'm gonna go into the articles in a minute. You know, I'll probably close it out on those articles. But seeing the time approaching, I mean, it's so hard to count the things that's been happening, because every single day is some crazy news. If it's not, like I said, it's not celebrities dying. It's the Venezuelan crisis. The shootings, is the bombings, whether it's France, or Amsterdam, or the Orlando shooting. Now you got more you Negroes and Hispanics getting gunned down. But then the cops. Yeah. But now the cops getting put to death, man. So now what? What is that going to lead to? That's going to lead to a civil war and ultimately a race war. So now. And this goes out to the Akim. Now we see these things happening. Let's get into these scriptures. I have a couple of scriptures I want to go into. First is this. Matthew chapter 6, verse 22. Let me see. Matthew 6, 22. And stuff is happening. It's not like you don't see it. The Most High is showing. People are crazy.
It's amazing to me.
Two Negroes getting killed. Yeah. Two Negroes got killed and then cops get killed. Are you stupid?
A spirit is stupid.
Yeah. No clue. No care in the world. But you think your life's not going to change? They gonna pass all kind of legislation. Yeah, your life is gonna change. The economy collapse. Your life is going to change. Get ready to get searched more. Get ready for there to be Well, you know they already got me.
Yeah.
How you doing, Dana? How you doing? Good. All right. Take care. All right. Like we saying. Your life is gonna change. All our life is gonna change. Because we all yeah. Like the Lord said, fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. It's like trying Yeah. See, none of those things is thou shalt suck. Cause some, a lot of our faith gonna get tried, man. We gonna get tried. We're gonna get tried on a whole nother level. But that's gonna be to your glory. Because the Son of Man has to go through that. That's why the scripture says this. I'm gonna read it now. Matthew 6, verse 22. People with no care in the world, because the scripture says the Most High. Matter of fact, let me read that first, and I'm gonna read Matthew. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 2. And only they sleep, they gonna go to church tomorrow and be even more asleep. Isaiah 60 and 2. It says, "For behold, darkness shall cover the whole earth," and that's right now, "and gross darkness the people." And that's what you see right now. This thick darkness over these people. Their mind is convoluted, man. They don't see it. And what you mean your eyes? You're talking about your spiritual eyes. Meaning the things that we say, they can't see it. Even though it's happening right in front of them. Even all the signs that the Bible told you would happen in the end is happening. They still can't see it. The Lord says shall be what? Nation against nation. Kingdom against kingdom. Wars, evils, pestilences, distress upon nation, signs in the sun, signs in the moon, all the blood moons that we had. People still don't get it. They still can't see it. And they go to church every week. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, it's just something to do. Yeah, to commit adultery. Or to just a fashion show, you know what I mean? It's just a tradition. It said, "But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee." And that's talking about the elect. That's what the Lord said. This Matthew 6:22, scripture I'm going to bring up. Matthew chapter 6 verse 22, and this goes to all the Akia, man, and sisters. This is what the Lord said. Matthew 6:22. The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thy eye be single, which he's talking about your mind, thy whole body shall be full of light. Meaning that what? If your mind, you got that tunnel vision on the kingdom of the Most High, and you focus on keeping the commandments, having faith, doing the work, the main ministry is coming out here. And you got brothers who do shows, you know, put clips together, sit downs, that also edify the flock. Right. Everybody got a different talent, different gift.
Yeah.
Like I showed a sister, a brother that's good with drawings. He's bringing the scriptures to life to you. That's his talent. That's his gift.
That's right.
So whatever gift the Most High gave you to edify his people, got to use it.
Yeah.
Because if you don't use it, there's a parable on that about the wicked servant who sat on his talent. What happened? The Lord put him to The Lord put him to death. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. The Lord what? He put him to death. The Lord, he tried to give the Lord back the same coin he gave, the same money, the talent he gave. And he said, the Lord was like, "What is this? I gave you this to produce more talents. Yeah. You gonna give me back my own money back with usury?" Gabe took that talent and he gave it to the guy that was productive. You got to be prolific in this truth, man. You got to make things happen.
Yeah.
Whether you got someone with you or not, you got to go out there and do it. This is your salvation, man. You got to show the Most High and His Son you want this kingdom. He promised you from the beginning. So whatever lot or talent that He gave you, perfect it, man. And if you're weak, pray, man. Pray for the gift of faith, man. Okay, you got to pray for that, man, because the times is coming. We all going to need it. So I'm going to read it again. Matthew 6:22. The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thy eye be single, if you have tunnel vision on the kingdom, like the Lord said, my will is to do it, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. It's about finishing.
Yeah.
Because you got a lot of guys who came in. Yeah, his work.
Not what we think we should be.
Yup. Because you had a lot of guys. How you doing? You had a lot of guys who came in and they fell out. Guess what? They're going to be destroyed, man. You never take your hand off the plow. There's judgment for that. All right? That's why it says, that's some scripture I want to go into. In fact, let me hold this on deck. It says, verse 23. But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. That's these people out here. No care in the world. Like the scripture says, men shall be lovers of pleasure more than lovers of the Most High. See? He's a prime example, man. He's fulfilling the lustful wickedness in his flesh, man. See? That's that. Scripture talks about that, man. Their mind is evil, man. That's common sense. Like, you really got to break down fertilization. Yeah. You really got to break down fertilization in the year 2016. And show people how people come on a planet Earth. Why do you come that way? Because that's the order he set up from the garden. Anything besides that is perverse.
There's something else. It's a perverted form. Just because I'm connected
doesn't mean the Most High is designed to be. Because you see it. They're demons, man. But it says this, verse 23. Yeah. Or verse 24. No man can serve two masters. For either ye will hate the one and love the other. So what? You can't be down with America, Babylon, and be down with the Most High. It don't go that way. Because the Most High is against this kingdom. The way it was set up and the things they uphold and they promote, he's not with it. That's the whole point. He's going to send his son back to throw down everything. The way the movie's going to end. Yeah. The way the movie going to end. Because this is his movie. That's the word. That's what the word God in Greek means. Theo. Theo or theater. This is his theater. And the main player is his son, Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
Who he's going to send back to cast down everything and to redeem the elect. So the Lord said, what? No man can serve two masters. So you can't have one pinky in the truth and your whole body is in darkness. It don't go that way. Because the Lord said, what? I'd rather you be cold or hot. But since you're lukewarm, I'm going to spit you out. I'm going to spew you out.
I know from that scripture.
Yeah.
And
God,
and it was in that scripture.
Yeah, you can't. And that goes for all of us. So any brother that's in that spirit, you better pray. And get that demon off of you and continue on that path. Because we all at times, we in the flesh.
Yeah.
So certain things will hinder you or get in your way. But like the Lord said, it's better you enter the kingdom mind than don't enter at all.
Yeah.
Meaning whatever hindrance is holding you down, yeah, whether it's a friend, whether it's a woman,
yeah,
you got to cut them off, man. Because it don't make sense you pleasing that person and you get destroyed along with it. Nah, man, this path to the kingdom is a lonely one, okay? The path to the heavens is a lonely one. That's why the word soldier means what? Solitude. Okay? So we all got to man up, man. That's right. And another thing you got to keep doing too, I'm going to read it. 2 Timothy 2:15 says, study, research, analyze, learn the scriptures, apply the scriptures. So the scripture says what? And we going to read for who? Study to show thyself approved unto the Most High. Not to man, please, a man. Or to show people I know a lot. To hell with these people, man. They can't save you, man. You got to please a higher power. You got to show him that you're worthy. So the scripture says, I'm going to read it. Study to show thyself approved unto the Most High, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Meaning what? Like the way I'm doing now.
Precept
upon precept.
Because, it
defines
itself.
Yeah. So meaning that what? You can't read the Bible like it's a novel. It's not a novel. And if you read it like that, like it's a storybook, it's going to throw you off. That's why even a publishers give you reference scriptures, because they know how to read the scriptures. All right? But anyway, it says this. John 21:15. And this is an important commandment. So you guys are sitting on your ass. Excuse my French. Better get up, okay? Because the Lord ain't playing, man. And you guys that's being comfortable in this truth, man. You are constant warfare on all levels, man. And we keep telling you, this devil, he about to bring it. Yeah.
I said this is gonna be. I said this is gonna be the most challenging year yet.
Yeah.
I said that last year. It's coming into the last of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. I like that.
Get ready.
Yeah. Get ready. That's why he said, "Let your eye be single. You have tunnel vision.
Looking over here and looking over there.
No. You're like you trying to do the truth." And you got things in the world. Damn, I'm trying to get this great job though, and this degree. Like, I want to see get my master's degree, man.
He taught me with what they did to me is your circumstances don't matter when it comes to your relationship with him and what you should be doing with that relationship with him. It does not matter. It matters because Jesus didn't matter.
And that can't save you. See, the money system is about to go down. That's why they're bringing forth the chip. They're going to get rid of that paper currency. They're not dealing with that no more. Everything is going to be digital. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's why it says this. Yup. And this is a commandment the Lord said to Simon Peter. We're going to read. John 21:15. Says, so when they had dined, Jesus, or Yahweh Shai, said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my lambs. You talking about physical food? No. It's word, man. As we said, man can't live on bread alone. By every word proceeded out of the mouth of the Most High. Verse 16. He said unto him again, the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? So the Lord said, if you love me, what did he say? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my sheep. So the Lord is saying, if you love me, do the work, man. That's what he's saying. Feed my sheep. And he told you where to go. For you brothers out there that got that talent. You got to come out. You got to be seen, man. Alright? And you got to be consistent. 17. He said unto him the third time. Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? He said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou know that I love thee. Yahweh Shai said unto him, feed my sheep. If you love me, do my work. Simple and plain. So it don't mean to take money from the congregation and spend it on your lavish lifestyle. You don't love the sheep. You're a wolf in sheep clothing. The Bible warned you about men like that. Creflo. So I know you hate hair nap. Right? No. I say you hate hair nap because you still like Creflo Dollar, right? See, you got to be against him. That man is the devil. I know he's an Israelite. I know he know that now, man. There's too much information out there. He ain't gonna teach that because his tax stipends. Because
I cannot say.
They'll take it away, man. And all false prophets, according to the Bible.
I have reasons for not, but I tell you.
The judgment for being a false prophet is death, man. The Lord don't take that lightly. You take his word and use it for your own agenda. He's going to kill you, man. Okay? This is above all of us, man. Okay? That's why the Lord even said what? John 12:49.
I'm not going to judge
judge him, because
some of the stuff I learned under him.
Because everybody examined this guy. The minute he did that jet ski, everybody condemned that guy. He's a demon for that. Well, he took $65 million to get his new jet. You don't care about that. When he asked the congregation for $65 million to buy a new jet.
This must have been recently.
This is this year.
Oh, yeah. It's this year. It's recent. Because I said that before.
Yeah, this guy is, come on, this guy is wicked. It says John 12:49. Well, we gonna do it. Because the Lord said this, John 15:1. I am the true vine, and my Father the husbandman. Every branch of me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it. And they bring forth more fruit. He said, verse 2. And like you said, Matthew 15:14, he said, if the blind lead the blind, they're both going to be destroyed. So if you follow in a false prophet, you're going to be destroyed unless you come out of that. See what I'm saying? Because I'm going to show you why. The scriptures get deep, man. It gets very deep. Ezekiel 14:9. It says, and if the prophet be deceived when he speaketh a thing, I the Lord have deceived that prophet, and I will stretch out my hand upon him, and I will destroy him from the midst of my people Israel. So the Most High is bad, man. He's bad. Most High is a bad dude. He said, if there's a false prophet, guess who set him up? I set him up, man. And then I'm going to destroy that man. See what I'm saying? Because he ain't of the elect, man. Meaning what? Certain men are set up as stumbling blocks to keep the people out that the Most High don't want. Deceive those group of people. I don't want him. And all of y'all going to be destroyed together. This is why you always got to examine yourself and be humble, man.